Welcome to the Insights of Microbiology. Today we are going to talk on the phenotypic detection of extended spectrum beta-lactamase producing gram-negative bacteria. First, let's see what are beta-lactamase enzymes. The beta-lactamase enzymes can simply be defined as enzymes produced by gram-negative bacteria, and these enzymes confer bacterial resistance to beta-lactam antibiotics. Examples of the beta-lactam antibiotics include penicillins, cephalosporins, carbapenems, and monobacter. Therefore, bacteria with the abilities to produce extended spectrum beta-lactamase enzymes, this is one among the beta-lactamase enzymes commonly produced by gram-negative bacteria. These bacteria will be able to hydrolyze the beta-lactam antibiotics previously mentioned. Therefore, the bacteria will become simply multi-drug resistant bacteria. So, there are substances which are known to inhibit the productions of extended spectrum beta-lactamase enzymes from these bacteria. And these substances or chemicals include clavulanic acid, tazobactam, and sulbactam. Therefore, with the phenotypic detection of these extended spectrum beta-lactamases producing bacteria, these beta-lactamase inhibitors are employed to phenotypically detect beta-lactamase producing gram-negative bacteria. A simple method is by the use of double disc synergy test, known as double disc synergy test. This test uses a disc, antibiotic disc with clavulanic acid. The clavulanic acid, this is known as an inhibitor of beta lactamase production. Inhibitor of beta lactamase production. So it will inhibit the bacteria from production of ESBL enzymes. We have mostly antibiotic susceptibility testing is performed on culture media. The culture media known as Mueller Inton Agar, abbreviated by MHL. A disc containing clavulanic acid after a standard inoculation of the media. A disc containing clavulanic acid is seeded on the surface of inoculated Mueller Inton Agar. This disc with the clavulanic acid, the disc with a clavulanic acid, it will be diffused to a certain perimeter. It is said diffused to this perimeter. Therefore, the inoculated bacteria is ESBL producer. The non-ESBL producer, inoculated bacteria. Therefore, bacterial cells within the perimeter where clavulanic acid diffused will be inhibited to produce ESBL enzymes. Will be inhibited to produce ESBL enzymes. Then simultaneous seeding of beta lactam antibiotics. These are beta lactam antibiotics. Let's say this is ceftriaxone and this is ceftazidime, the third generation cephalosporins, beta lactam antibiotics. They will also be diffused to a certain perimeter. They will also be diffused to a certain perimeter. So the beta lactam antibiotic will be diffused to a certain perimeter. And the intersection part, this is the intersection part between the beta lactam antibiotic, ceftazidime, and an antibiotic, this containing clavulanic acid. Here, the bacterial cells were inhibited from production of ESBL enzymes. Therefore, they will be susceptible towards ceftazidime. And here on the intersection, at the intersection of ceftriaxone and an antibiotic disc containing clavulanic acid, bacteria were inhibited from production of ESBL enzymes. Therefore, they will be susceptible towards ceftriaxone. So here bacteria will be killed. And here bacteria will be killed before their growth. So there will be a zone. There will be a zone of inhibition. Zones of inhibition of ceftriaxone and ceftazidime enhanced towards a disc containing clavulanic acid. A phenomenon like this one will be observed. A phenomenon like this one will be observed. This is an antibiotic disc containing clavulanic acid. This is a third generation cephalosporin disc, ceftazidime, and you see this part of inhibition towards a disc containing clavulanic acid. So this is what will be seen. Therefore, during interpretation, this isolate is termed as ESBL phenotype. Phenotype because the phenotypic characteristics of ESBL enzymes production is observed on the Muller-Eaton agar after antibiotic susceptibility testing. Thank you for watching. Share to your fellows.